हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम इनिशिएटेड बाय श्री ज्ञानमंदिर विद्यापीठ फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8. वंस अगेन नाइस टू सी यू इन टुडे सोशल साइंस लेक्चर फॉर सेमिस्टर 1. टॉपिक दैट वी हैव इनिशिएटेड एंड वी आर लर्निंग इज मेंशन्ड ऑन द बोर्ड एज यू कैन सी व्हाट इज अराउंड अस, चैप्टर नंबर 2. इन द लास्ट टू लेक्चर्स we came across the two important topics, that is, what is earth made up of? Well, Dhanvi's mother tried to satisfy the son's curiosity and explained about the lithosphere and the hydrosphere. So out of the four spheres that we have to learn in this chapter, we've already covered two of them in the last two lectures. So let me put up the things that we have covered and what we are going to cover today. The spheres that we are going to learn about in this chapter are the lithosphere. So we've learned about lithosphere, the layer of rocks or the rocky layer, hydrosphere. We learned about the layer of water, so the solid sphere we have covered and the liquid sphere we have covered. So these are the two spheres we have learned in the last two lectures. So in today's lecture we will be acknowledging ourselves, taking up some extensive information about the next sphere that we need to know, that is atmosphere. Well, so let us go and read from the content, the material that we have in our hand on page number 14. Have a careful look and read the important things that are marked out over there and try to remember those points because they are very important. The passage about atmosphere on page 14. The sphere of air that wraps the earth from all sides is called atmosphere. So this is the stipulated definition of atmosphere. When you are sitting at your place and where I am standing at my place, the surrounding, wherever we see or wherever I can swish my hands, I can move about my hands, though I cannot touch it, but I can feel, I can experience that when the wind blows. So all that is surrounding me can be called as a blanket of atmosphere, what we refer to as air. So the sphere of air, we're talking about the sphere of air, all that is surrounding me, the sphere of air that wraps the earth. So the entire earth is wrapped by, covered by a layer of air, and this layer of air which is surrounding the entire earth is known to be or called as atmosphere. Well, let us take some more extensive information about the sphere or atmosphere. It extends approximately up to 1600 kilometers from the surface of the earth. So we live on the earth over here, and this phenomena or this layer of the gases or air is extended from the surface of the earth up above the sky. When you go towards the sky, it is extended all the way up to 1600 kilometers, and in this entire distance of 1600 kilometers upwards, it is divided into different fragments, which about which we will be learning soon. So the approximate extension of the atmosphere from the surface of the earth towards the sky is around 1600 kilometers from the surface of the earth. Well, it cannot be seen. The next important thing, it cannot be seen clearly with the naked eyes. Now you can't see air with naked eyes, isn't it? It is something that is not visible to us. Like lithosphere and hydrosphere, atmosphere is composed of various gases, water vapor, dust particles, smoke, salt, microorganism, etc. So all this is the composition of the entire atmosphere. So you need to remember each one of this carefully. So atmosphere is made up of, built up of different gases. Gases like hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen that is required for us to live, and all these things. water vapor, that is the moisture content in the air, what is referred to as water vapor. And dust particles, well, dust particles are always there in the atmosphere. Smoke, salt, microorganisms, etc. There are many more things also in the atmosphere. Further, atmosphere is colorless. Can we see the atmosphere? Does it have any color? No. When you look around yourself, you can see so many objects around you, isn't it? That's the name of the chapter, what is around us. But this one thing that we are talking about right now, that is atmosphere, can only be felt. It can only be felt, but you cannot touch it or see it with your naked eyes. And nor does it have any color in it. So it is colorless, it is odorless. So odor means smell. So you cannot smell it. It does not have any particular smell. But yes, if you spray some kind of perfume on surrounding you, you naturally smell that perfume. But there is no particular smell for the atmosphere. The air that you breathe in does not have its own fragrance or smell. Therefore, it is odorless. So it is colorless, odorless, and transparent. So it is transparent in nature. It is not visible to us. It is highly transparent. Solid, liquid, and gaseous elements are included in the atmosphere. So the atmosphere is not only having just gases, not only it has gaseous things inside, it has got solid things also. The dust particles, we can say, though they are very minute, but they comprise of the solid in nature. So it has got solid substances, it has got liquid substances. We're talking about the moisture, the water vapor, which is liquid, present in the atmosphere. And we have got gaseous substance also, as I just said, that the air is comprised of a different kinds of gases. Well, it contains approximately 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, and 1% of other gases. So the other gases includes helium, argon, and so on. We'll be discussing about this soon. Reading further from the text, we have, when we go higher from the surface of the earth, the amount of most of the gases in the atmosphere decreases. So as one leaves the earth and go towards the sky, what happens? The content or the amount of gases keep on decreasing. The oxygen level decreases, the other gases also decrease, because as you are moving towards the sky, you are going away from the atmosphere. So what happens? The air becomes thinner, the proportion or the amount of gases in it becomes lighter and thinner. Well, so the gases keep decreasing in the atmosphere. Carbon dioxide is heavy. Carbon dioxide gas is heavy, so it is found more in the lower layer of the air. So if you compare the layer of air to a plain region compared to a mountainous region or hill station, you will find that the mountainous or the hill station has less number of gases. It has got less number of oxygen, definitely. But along with it, it does not have that much of carbon dioxide in it also. Compared to when you are keeping yourself and where you are living in a plain region, you will find the carbon dioxide has a heavy proportion of gas inside, thus composition of air. So carbon dioxide, being a heavy gas, is found more in the lower layer of air compared to the higher altitudes. You can see and analyze the picture given to you about the four spheres over here, human life and spheres. So the life of human depends upon all these three spheres. Earlier we learned about the lithosphere, where we make our dwellings, we make our houses. So if there is no lithosphere, you will not be able to construct our shelter places or our shelter. Similarly, when you talk about the hydrosphere, it is a very important sphere with which we make a number of uses of it. We need potable water for drinking, which is procured from the hydrosphere. So it plays a vital role in the existence, in the sustenance of living beings. Similarly, atmosphere, the air that we breathe in, the oxygen that is required for human beings to keep alive, is available from this sphere. So all the three spheres are very, very important, and a picture related to that has been shown to you in the page. Reading further, ozone gas comprises of a very small proportion in the air. So along with other gases, we have another gas, the ozone gas. Now this gas absorbs the ultraviolet rays. What is its important role? What is the role it plays? Why is it so important? Because it absorbs the ultraviolet rays from the sun and protects the earth from excessive heat of the sun. The sun is very bright, very, very hot. So it sends some unwanted or some harmful rays, the ultraviolet rays, the UV rays, towards the earth. But it is the role of the ozone which protects us from this kind of gas or this kind of dangerous gases. So this gas is absorbed by, is taken in by the ozone gas or the ozone layer, what we talk about. And therefore the earth is protected from excessive heat. No doubt we feel a lot of heat, but these days we have a problem of global warming. The reason being, the ozone layer is gradually getting damaged. So this gas is more in proportion in the morning in the open ground and in the air near the sea. So where do you find the maximum proportion or the maximum amount of ozone gas? It is in these two places. In the morning time in the open ground, if you go, you will find. Therefore we are in the habit of going for morning walks so that we can remain healthy. And it is found more near the sea. Further, gases like oxygen and nitrogen keeps the living creatures on the earth alive. Naturally, isn't it? This is very important for us. So oxygen is a very important gas, which is a composition of the air that we breathe in, which keeps us alive. Further, what is the importance of nitrogen in our life? Nitrogen reduces the intensity of oxygen. Nitrogen reduces the intensity of oxygen. Water is the most important component in the atmosphere. Therefore, we know that water is very important for our sustenance of life. Due to heat, the water in the form of vapor evaporates and mixes with air, which is known as moisture. So this is one terminology that you should remember, moisture. The process of cooling of the vapor is called condensation. You must have learned this in the science class also, in the earlier standards, in the lower classes. The process of cooling of the vapor. When the vapor cools down in the higher altitudes, the higher layers of the sky or the space, what happens? It falls down as rain. This phenomena is called the condensation of the water vapor. Various forms of moisture is available, like dew. Dew is one form of moisture. Fog is another form of moisture. You must have seen dew. Dew drops on, settled on the leaves in the morning during the winter season, particularly when it is very cold outside. And if you wake up early in the morning around 4 or 5 o'clock, and if you observe the plants, you will find droplets of water settled on its leaves. What is this kind of water vapor? This is the form called dew. Similarly, when it is very cold, a layer or a moisture or the dust particles get trapped in that moisture and creating a hazy visualization or hazy view. This is called fog. So two forms of water vapor, dew and fog. Then the most important one that we experience almost throughout the year, that is clouds. The clouds that you see in the sky is a form of water vapor, and precipitation are due to condensation. So all these things happen due to condensation. Condensation is responsible for the creation of dew, fog, clouds, and precipitation. The effects of atmosphere is seen on human beings in every aspect of life. Well, we human beings try to get adapted to the climatic changes that happen around us. So atmosphere plays a very vital role or creates a great effect or an impact on human beings. If it is too cold, what happens? We put on the winter wears, the sweaters, the mufflers, because we need to protect ourselves from some harsh cold. Similarly, the climatic conditions that change during the summer season or the rainy season, accordingly we have to adapt to ourselves. So the effect of the atmosphere is directly seen on human beings in every aspect of life. It is not only about the wearing of the clothes. It is about the food habits. It is about the houses that we make. If somebody is living in a very cold place, what happens? Their houses are made accordingly. Or someone lives in a very, in a place where there is a lot of rain, it rains heavily, the roofs of the houses are made in a sloping form, unlike the ones we have, the flat roofs in our houses over here in Gujarat. So what happens? The atmosphere plays a great impact on every walk of our life, every aspect of us, such as their food habits, clothings, habitat, that is the dwelling places, color. The colors of the skin also keeps changing. People who are living in very hot climatic regions, you will find that their skin is very, very dark. And economic activities as well. The type of economic activities, that is money earning activities, is called economic activities. That is also dependent upon the atmospheric conditions where a person is living. Say if someone is living in the coastal regions, his economic activity would be fishing, or he would be making some activity to sail people or transportation on the water or waterways. So it depends on where the person is living. So if someone is living in the mountainous regions, his activity would be about rearing sheep and animals and cattle. If someone living in the plain regions, he would be involved in farming. So it depends from person to on the basis of atmosphere, how the person to person works. Well, so atmosphere plays a great impact on all these aspects of our life: food habits, clothing, habitat, color, economic activities, etc. Many dust particles are seen in the atmosphere. Spreading of sun rays are visible due to these particles. So now we are talking about the dust particles. The dust particles that you see, sometimes if you have if you carefully observe the rays of the sunlight, you may find small dust particles floating everywhere. You may have experienced this. So there are freely suspended dust particles all around us. Now when light gets passed through this, what happened? It refracts, or it reflects the light. So dust particles play an important role in spreading the light. The light rays that we see, or the sunlight that is spread everywhere around us during the morning time, who is responsible for this? The dust particle responsible for this. So dust particle plays an important role in the spreading of light, and that is how we are able to view things. So sun rays are visible due to these particles. It is due to the dust particles that it does not suddenly turn dark after the sunset and does not suddenly turn bright after the sunrise. You must have experienced this. As the sun starts rising, what happened? Gradually the light keeps spreading everywhere, and then it becomes completely bright. If you observe the first coming out of the light of the sun in the morning time. Similarly, when it becomes dark in the evening, all of a sudden it doesn't get dark. Say if you put off the tube light, what happens? Suddenly it gets dark. But it does not happen with the sun. When the sun goes down or when the sun rises, gradually it becomes brighter and gradually it becomes darker. So the dust particle is playing an important role in the happening of this phenomena. So the sun rays are reflected back with the help of these dust particles on the surface of the earth, and we receive the sunlight of the sun. This is how we receive the sunlight of the earth and the spreading of the sunlight. Further, what is the role of the atmosphere? The underlined words have been given to you, which is very important for you to remember. We are able to listen to sound due to the presence of the atmosphere. So you see, atmosphere plays a very vital role in the propagation or the spreading of sound. So we are able to listen when we talk to someone sitting here around, or when general talk, communication you are doing with person to person. So what is responsible? It is the medium, that is the atmosphere, which travels the sound waves and reaches to your ear. So we are able to listen to the sound due to the presence of atmosphere. That is why radio and Doordarshan telecast is possible. So we are able to see the things on the television is because of the waves that travel through the atmosphere, and we catch the signal with the help of our receivers. So atmosphere plays a very significant role in transporting sound from one place to another. Well, you've been given a thinking activity over here. Let's go through it. On the basis of which experience can you state that atmosphere exists on the surface of the earth? So it's a think question. Think about it and try to share your views. Well, This was about the atmosphere that we read from the content given to us. We will now try to talk about a bit of the details about atmosphere and some other gases and the different layers of the atmosphere. So have a look at the image being displayed on your screen, which will provide you some additional information. The image provides the information about the definition of atmosphere once again. So let's read it together. Atmosphere is a protective layer of gases that shelters all life on Earth, keeping temperatures within a relatively small range and blocking out harmful rays of the sunlight. An atmosphere is a blanket of gases that surrounds Earth. It is held near the surface of the planet by the Earth's gravitational attraction. Argon, oxygen, and nitrogen from the three main constitutions of the atmosphere. So you see, the entire Earth is surrounded by a blanket of gases, and the planet Earth, due to its gravitational force, attracts this blanket of gases towards it, which comprises of these gases, say argon, oxygen, and nitrogen, which are the three main constituents of the atmosphere. Further, the atmosphere contains the air that we breathe. So the air that we breathe is a part of this atmosphere. The atmosphere helps retain the sun's heat and prevent it from escaping back into the space. So the sunlight that comes into the atmosphere does not go back due to the atmosphere. So atmosphere plays a role of retaining the heat that comes on the Earth and traps it. Protects life from harmful radiation from the sun, as we discussed about the ozone layer. Plays a major role in the Earth's water cycle. So atmosphere also plays a major role in the Earth's water cycle. We learned about the water cycle in the topic about hydrosphere. It helps keep the climate on the Earth moderate. It keeps the climate moderate balanced. It does not become too hot or too cold. No doubt, we have the hottest places and the coldest places in the world. So it helps keep the climate on the Earth moderate. That's the role of the atmosphere. Well, there is no boundary between the atmosphere and outer space. The atmosphere gets less dense and denser until it blends into the outer space. So as one travels from the surface of the Earth towards the sky, as we just understood that it extends up to 1600 kilometers approximately. So as it extends from the Earth towards the space, the atmosphere gets less dense and denser until it gets mixed into the outer space. Next is the layers of atmosphere. What do you see when you stand outside and look up? A blue sky, isn't it? A group of clouds. At night, you might see a crescent moon, stars, a satellite. What you are not seeing, however, is the complexity of our atmosphere. The atmosphere has five distinct layers. They are determined by the changes in the temperature that happen when increasing altitude. The layers of the Earth's atmosphere are divided into five different layers as exosphere, thermosphere, mesosphere, stratosphere, and troposphere. Let us now find out some more about the layers of the atmosphere and their importance. As you can see the image being shown to you, the atmosphere has five distinct layers: troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. Well, the stratosphere contains the ozone layer as well, as you can see the sublayer given to you, and the Kármán line and the exobase over here in the exosphere. Well, this is the hierarchical arrangement of the various layers of the Earth's atmosphere. Let us read and understand in detail about each of these layers. The first one is troposphere. The troposphere is the lowest layer in the atmosphere. It extends upwards to about 10 kilometers above sea level. So from the sea level, if you start traveling upwards, you will find the troposphere extended all the way up to 10 kilometers from the sea level, starting from the ground level. The lowest part of the troposphere is called the boundary layer and the topmost layer. It is called the tropopause. So remember these names. The troposphere contains 75% of all air in the atmosphere. So of all the air that we understand, we see, or we can say we experience, 75% of all the air is in the atmosphere, is present in the troposphere. Most clouds appear in this layer because 99% of the water vapor in the atmosphere is found here. Therefore, clouds are formed in this layer, in the troposphere. The water that gets evaporated rises up and forms the, or formation of cloud happens in the troposphere. Temperature and air pressure drop as you go higher in the troposphere. So when one leaves from the surface of the earth and travels towards the first layer, that is troposphere, the pressure of air and temperature drops. It becomes colder over there. When a parcel of air moves upwards, it expands. When air expands, it cools. Due to this reason, the base of the troposphere is warmer than its base, because the air in the surface of the earth absorbs the sun's energy, gets heated up and moves upward as a result, which it cools down. The next layer of atmosphere is stratosphere. Above the troposphere lies the stratosphere, which extends from the top of the troposphere to about 50 kilometers, 31 miles above the ground. The ozone layer lies within the stratosphere. So ozone layer, what we talk about, is in this sphere of the earth, or this sphere of the atmosphere, that is stratosphere. Ozone molecules, or the gases of the ozone molecules in this layer, has the ability to absorb the high energy ultraviolet rays, or the UV rays from the sun, and convert it into heat. Because of this happening, unlike the troposphere, the stratosphere gets warmer the higher you go. So when you travel on the stratosphere, or when you are in the stratosphere, it is a bit warmer over here. The next layer is the mesosphere. Above the stratosphere is the mesosphere, and this layer extends to a height of about 85 kilometers, that is 53 miles from the ground. So all these measurements are taken from the surface of the earth or the ground. Here the temperature grows colder as you rise up through the mesosphere. So when you travel in the mesosphere, when you are in that particular part, the temperature is very, very cold over here. The coldest parts of our atmosphere are located in this layer and can reach up to minus 90 degrees centigrade. So the temperature over here can be felt around minus 90 degrees centigrade when you are in the mesosphere. The next layer is thermosphere, which lies above the mesosphere. And in this region, where the temperature increases as you go higher up, the temperature increase is caused due to the absorption of the energetic ultraviolet rays and X-ray radiation from the sun. However, the air in this layer is not so thin that it would feel freezing cold to us. Satellites orbit Earth within the thermosphere. Temperatures in the upper thermosphere can range from about 500 degrees to 2000 degrees centigrade, or even higher. The aurora, the northern lights and southern lights, occur in the thermosphere. The next layer, or the next distinct layer of the atmosphere, is exosphere. Now, exosphere is the final frontier of the Earth's gaseous envelope. The air in the exosphere is constantly but gradually leaking out of the Earth's atmosphere into outer space. There is no clear-cut upper boundary where the exosphere finally fades away into the space. So we can say exosphere is a kind of a boundary expelling outside into the space. Almost we can say it's the border or the boundary where the atmosphere would be coming to an end. Finally, we have the fifth and the last sphere, that is the ionosphere. The ionosphere isn't a distinct layer, unlike other layers in the atmosphere, what we talk about. The ionosphere is a series of regions in the parts of the mesosphere and thermosphere where high energy radiation from the sun has knocked electrons loose from their parent atoms and molecules. So that is the ionosphere that we understood about. So these were the five different layers that we understood about in details. Well, let us now summarize these layers of atmosphere in a quick manner. Have a look at the chart being displayed to you, the summary of the layers of atmosphere, which will be a handy reference for you. So remember this. Alternatively, you can take a screenshot of the same and preserve it. The chart gives us information about summary of the layers of the atmosphere. As you can see, it contains the four regions, namely the troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere and thermosphere. Well, the fifth name is not mentioned over here, as we already discussed that ionosphere isn't a distinct layer. Therefore, the chart contains only the information about the four distinct layers of atmosphere. The troposphere has an altitude range from 0 kilometers, that is from the surface of the earth all the way up to the sky, that is 11 kilometers. In this region, one can experience temperature ranging from 15 degrees centigrade to minus 56 degrees centigrade. Important characteristics about this sphere is that the weather occurs over here. So all that weather we talk about is comprised or is in the troposphere. Stratosphere ranges, the altitude ranges from 11 kilometers all the way up to 50 kilometers towards the sky. The temperature ranging from minus 56 to minus 2, and the ozone layer is present over here. We understood about the ozone layer, which absorbs the harmful ultraviolet rays and protects the earth. So the ozone layer is present in a stratosphere. Remember this. Next is mesosphere. The altitude ranges from 50 kilometers to 85 kilometers towards the space or towards the sky. The temperature ranges from minus 2 to minus 92 degrees. And the important characteristic of this layer is the meteors that try to enter into the earth or come towards the earth. They get burnt over here in this layer. So meteors burn in this layer is the special important characteristics of this layer of atmosphere, that is mesosphere. The fourth one, which is say the verge of the completion of the atmosphere, thermosphere, ranges from 85 kilometers to 800 kilometers. And the temperature here ranges between minus 92 degrees to 1200 degrees. And it has an important characteristic, that is the auroras occur over here. Well, let's ask a question to ourselves. What would happen if the Earth's atmosphere disappeared? Have you ever thought about it? Well, have you ever wondered what would happen if the Earth lost its atmosphere, if the atmosphere was not present or it breaks down? What could happen? Well, we have the possibilities that we are going to read and understand. Birds and planes would fall from the sky. Although we can't see air, it has a mass that supports flying objects. So the air has a mass, although it is not visible to us, as we just learned earlier, that air is such a thing that cannot be seen. It is transparent, odorless and colorless. We can't see it. But it plays a vital medium and supports the birds and planes to fly. So if it is not present, or it would come to an end, or it disappeared, what would happen? The birds and the planes would straight away fall down on the ground. So the atmosphere plays a vital role in the flying of birds and planes. Second thing that could happen is the sky would turn black. Why would the sky would turn black? Because the sky gets its color blue due to the atmosphere. Gases and particles in the Earth's atmosphere get scattered or scatter sunlight in all directions. As we learned earlier, that the gases and particles present in the Earth's atmosphere is responsible for the scattering of the sunlight. Now, when the atmosphere is not present, what happens? The scattering would not happen. And not only that much, the blue light is scattered more than other colors because it travels as shorter, smaller waves. And that is why we see the color of the sky most of the time blue. The next thing that could happen is there would be no sensation of sound, no propagation of sound. One would not be able to listen to one another because the medium atmosphere is now absent, and therefore sound waves will not travel. Although you could feel vibrations from the ground, you wouldn't hear anything because sound requires a medium to travel, and atmosphere is that medium which helps sound to propagate or sound to travel. But if it is not present, there is no question of sound traveling, and we will not be able to listen to any kind of sound, and nor we would be able to listen to what person to person is talking to. Next thing that could happen if the Earth's atmosphere disappeared is all the water bodies such as rivers, lakes and oceans would start to boil. The water would start boiling. Now you see, why would water start boiling? Because the harmful rays that come in on the Earth from the sun, the ultraviolet rays, the x-rays, all this would heat up the Earth a lot, heat up the water bodies, and it would be highly heated up, and therefore the water inside the oceans would start boiling. That much of heat would get trapped over here or would come to the Earth's surface. Therefore it would boil up the ocean. Boiling occurs when the vapor pressure of a liquid exceeds external pressures. In a vacuum, the water readily boils, easily starts boiling. Finally, the last point, organisms that breathe air to survive would die. Naturally, all living organisms would die. You would not be able to breathe the air. So these are the certain points that would happen, or incidences would happen, if the atmosphere disappeared. Let us talk about the other gases with the help of the image being displayed to you. Helium, neon, methane, nitrous oxide and ozone, and carbon dioxide. The composition of the other gases have been displayed to you with the help of this pie chart. Traces of hydrogen, neon, helium, nitrous oxide, ozone and other noble gases. But generally, a variable amount of water vapor is also present, on average about 1% at sea level. So the composition of each of these gases has been mentioned over here in this pie chart. You can see helium is 1.299%, whereas neon is 4.675, methane is 0.442 and nitrous oxide 0.078. Finally, ozone is very less, 0.010%. The most one is the carbon dioxide, 93.49. Well, here are some frequently asked questions that come to our mind, and we should be able to answer these questions. What is the greenhouse effect? Where does the Earth's atmosphere end? Why do passenger jet planes and commercial aeroplanes prefer flying in the stratosphere and not any other sphere? Which layer of the atmosphere contains the ozone layer? And the final question, which instrument is used to measure the air pressure? So let's go through each of these answers. The process of gases in the Earth's atmosphere trapping the sun's heat is known as the greenhouse effect. Due to this process, the Earth is much warmer than it would be without an atmosphere. The greenhouse effect is one of the things that makes Earth a comfortable place to live. The next question, where does the Earth's atmosphere end? Well, the Earth's atmosphere does not end at a specific place. The higher we go, the thinner the atmosphere gets. So there is no clear distinct instruction, or where we can say that here the atmosphere ends. Distinction between the atmosphere and outer space. Well, around 75% of the atmosphere is within 11 kilometers of the Earth's surface. Next question, why do passenger jet planes and commercial aeroplanes prefer flying in this particular sphere, that is stratosphere? Well, jet planes fly in the lower stratosphere because of less turbulence, less interference of the atmospheric conditions in the stratosphere, leading to a smooth ride. So when a jet plane or a commercial plane flies in the stratosphere, there is less turbulence experience, less disturbance experience with the object. So planes usually flow near the border between the troposphere and the stratosphere. Next question, which layer of atmosphere contains the ozone layer? Where we answer this question, the stratosphere contains the ozone layer. The stratospheric ozone layer absorbs most of the sun's ultraviolet rays and thereby protects the Earth. Finally, which instrument is used to measure the pressure of the air pressure? So the answer is very simple. A barometer is used to measure the air pressure. So I hope the information that I tried to provide you with the help of the images and from the content that we read is quite useful to you. You must have understood about the same. Well, as a part of the homework, it is important for us to write the things. So note down the homework that I give you. You'll have to write the short note about the atmosphere given to you on page number 23. Write a short note on atmosphere, and the points have been given to you, the definition, the characteristics, the utility and the composition. So note down the homework, write a short note on atmosphere. That is going to be your homework for today. So do the homework and submit the images, the screenshot, the PDF files, perhaps after the lecture. So I hope you enjoyed today's lecture. See you soon in the next lecture with some information about the biosphere in a detailed manner. Till then, take care, have a nice day, and goodbye.